Watch out, because the latest Windows update that you probably already installed last week has been reportedly causing SSDs to fail. Reports are still scattered, but there's enough people talking about it that it probably is true in this case, and Microsoft is actually investigating. So I'm gonna quickly go over what the problem is and also how to uninstall the update, especially if you got the same error that I was getting. I was able to actually figure out the solution to that, and I don't think anyone else has been able to figure it out yet, so we'll get to that. The problem does seem to be exclusive to Windows 11. Specifically, the update is KB5063878, and what people noticed is with many different SSDs, and it's very scattered, and it's not exactly clear which ones are affecting it other than certain manufacturer, the controllers. Basically, if you write a large amount of data sequentially, usually around 50 gigabytes or more, in some cases, it can cause the SSD to just disappear off the system and won't show up in the disk manager or anything. It will usually come back if you reboot, but in some cases it doesn't. And then those people apparently just lost the data, entire drives worth. And even in the latter case where it comes back, there could be data corruption and stuff. Some people have done some testing and it's kind of inconsistent which drives this occurs on, but it at least includes Samsung drives and Western Digital drives, which are probably some of the most popular ones. Probably the best testing that someone did was with a whole bunch of these drives where they copied a 92 gigabyte Cyberpunk game folder onto the drive. It's like 100 gigabytes around there. And then they did two other steps where they compressed that big folder on the same drive into a compressed archive and then also extracted that archive and then charted which drives failed at different stages. And you can see that they kind of failed at different points. Some of them didn't fail at all. And I've highlighted here in orange ones that failed but were recoverable by restarting, and then the one in red just didn't come back at all. So I would personally not take a chance, and usually in most cases I would be the last one to suggest that you uninstall or roll back a security update, but I did look through all the vulnerabilities that this security update patched, and it looks like there were no zero-day vulnerabilities, at least for the Windows desktop versions at least. Or in other words, none of the vulnerabilities that Microsoft patched were being actively exploited. They were not disclosed. So theoretically, no one should actually even know at this point how to exploit the stuff that Microsoft patched. So you aren't really putting yourself at extra risk in this case from uninstalling it. The risk, I think, of data loss is much greater and warrants rolling back the update. So if you decide you want to roll back the update, which I personally did, what you do is go into the Windows Update settings and then go down to Update History, then scroll all the way to the bottom and click Uninstall Updates and look for the one that says KB5063878, and then you could click Install. It'll ask you whether or not you want to restart after it uninstalls, but first I would actually pause updates in the main Windows Update settings so it doesn't just restart and then reinstall it again. Now, in some cases, you may get this error, which I actually did. It's 0x800F0825, and I was actually able to figure out the solution to this, which is to turn off the Windows Sandbox feature temporarily if you have it enabled. So you basically go into the Turn Windows Features On and Off menu, uncheck it, hit OK, it'll uninstall. Then you'll have to restart your computer to fully uninstall it. And after you do that and reboot, you will be able to uninstall the update, or at least should. If it happens again, there might be something else, but at least in my case, that's what did it. So then after you do uninstall the update, reboot again, then you should be able to just re-enable the Windows Sandbox feature. And I have seen a decent number of people with that same error, and as far as I know, I'm the only person that figured out how to solve it. Basically, if you look in the cbs.log Windows log file for the Windows Update stuff, it has a line that says the container base layer depends on LCU version greater than that version, and the container base layer has to do with the Windows Sandbox. So I turned off the feature and then it worked. So just a bit of a warning video. Personally, I would roll back the update. So yeah, let me know what you think. And if you want to keep watching, the next video I'd recommend is where I talked about some Windows registry tweaks that you'll actually probably want to know about. I'll put that link right there. And if you want to subscribe, I try to make videos about twice a week, so it should be worth it. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.